Good morning, everyone. Today, we are going to do a flooding analysis. First, let's open our global mapper and let's open one reference shape in order to georeference ourselves. We'll take an example of a site in Iraq. Therefore, we have to be careful to set up our global mapper with the right projection, which is UTM 38 North. If you don't know how to choose the projection and why to choose the projection, I refer to our tutorial about projection. Let's see now where we are, downloading imagery of the area. We see that our site is behind a river, that's the Tigris River. Therefore, we are going to do a flooding analysis considering the water of this river. First of all, we need to draw with a line the river. We can use the imagery and we can follow the visible stream. You don't need to be very, very precise. Once these streams have been drawn, a simple line will appear and we will create a shape file, a line shape file. We have to give the name of the layer and the name of the river and finally click OK. Now we see we just have the site and the river. At this point we have to convert our river in a shape. In order to do that, we have to select all the line and go to advanced features and create buffer. We write the name of the new layer that we are going to create, one buffer, and we write the size of our buffer. Let's say 25 meters. Once this is created, we have a shape and no more a line. The line is still there, but we can deactivate it. At this point, we can even color the line in blue just to show that this is the river. This shape now doesn't have any elevation. That's just a shape. That's why at this point, we have to add the elevation to this shape. How we do? We download the digital terrain model, in this case SRTM. At this point we select the polygon of the river. We go with the mouse over the polygon. We right click on it and select analysis measurement, apply elevation to selected features. Now source of elevation, terrain layer. At this point, our polygon, our river, has received all the elevation and the simulation can be done. The question is, how many meters shall we increase the water of the river in order to simulate a realistic flooding? Is it 1, 2, 3, or 4 meters? We don't have an answer unless we go on the field and we start investigate with the local people and we ask the location of the highest water level during the rainy period. We might collect several points that we have to record in our GPS and transfer into the map. That's what we did. And now we have 3 points that are showing the level that the water reached during the rainy season. We need now to activate our digital terrain model and at the same time we need to select the river polygon as a reference. At this point we can go to analysis, simulate water reservoir flooding, and we can start the flooding.
We have to write the name of the layer that we are going to create, write the meters that we are going to increase the water level, and important is to check the option increase from selected area. Now the first flooding appears as a simulation of 2 meters increasement of the water. As you can see, the water did not reach yet our reference point. Therefore, we can increase the water level of 1 meter, let's say 3 meters in this case. We change the name of the layer, same option, and we see the result. Also in this case, the 3 reference points have not been reached. That's why we redo the simulation with higher elevation up to the moment that we reach our reference point. We simulate 3, 4 and 5 meters, and we can see that the increasement of 5 meters reach almost all the 3 points of the reference. At this point, we have to improve the presentation of our flooding. We consider just the flooding of 5 meters. We select it, we right-click on it, and we select combine area. This converts all the shapes in one single flooding shape. A new layer is created and needs to be named accordingly. This is done so far, but at this point we want to smooth as well the perimeter of this area. Again, we select the newly created area, we go to vertex, and finally we select smooth. You will see now the flooding will look much more smooth. At this point, you double click on the layer and you change the display option. You make it blue and transparent, and the layer of the flooding looks nice on the map. At this point, we have now the flooding displayed over the river, 5 meter water increasement. And we can see that part of the camp is flooded. This means either we need to protect the camp or we need to relocate it before a disaster happens. But this is not all. We also want to see how our camp behaves in case of heavy rain. And this is a different type of flooding analysis. This flooding analysis of the sites in case of a heavy rain, and will identify lowland or depression on a flooded area in case of a bad drainage system. For this analysis, the water of the river is not considered. First, let's zoom in our site. Let's activate the digital terrain model. And let's make a watershed analysis. For the first attempt, we will just put the size of the area as a 50, and let's see what happens. The rest, we keep it like it is. The drain seems to be kind of real, and I would say we can accept them. At this point, we need just to delete all the drains that are not influencing our site. Means drains which are far. We take the selection tool and we select with the mouse all the drains outside of our camp, including the river. Because the flooding analysis with the river water has been done already. Once selected, we can delete them. At this point, we have all the drain
which are somehow influencing our site. All the natural drain outside of our site have been deleted. Like in the previous analysis, we have now to convert the drainage into polygon. You select the layer, you go with the mouse over the lines and select Advanced Features Creation Options. There you will find Buffer. You have to create there a new layer with a name and estimate the width for your drain, for example 1 meter. Then you click OK and the buffer is done. At this point, like before, we have to assign to the drainage polygon the elevation. For this reason, we select the drain polygon, we activate the digital terrain model, and then we right click on it and select analysis measurement, apply elevation to selected features. At this point, the drain have received the elevation as well. We can do now the flooding analysis based on the water in the drain. We select analysis, simulate water rise, we give the name of the layer that we are going to create, and here we will increase the water in the drain of, for example, 1 meter. We will increase the resolution since we are dealing with a small area. Let's say 5 meter resolution is very high resolution and it might take some time to run the analysis. Since the resolution is very high, I need to speed up the video. At this point, we have simulated the flooding in our site, considering 1 meter water increment on the natural drain. As before, we have to nicely displace the flooding in the cam. We zoom in. We deselect the digital terrain model. We select all the flooding areas. We move with the mouse over it, right click it, and we select crop combine. We say OK, and all the flooded area will be combined to one unique flooded area. At this point, we can change the color of the flooding area, like usually, to it blue and semi-transparent. Now we can combine the flooding of the river together with the flooding of the drainage and display the final flooding maps. Select both flooding area, go with the cursor over it, right click it and select combine. A new layer is going to be created. This layer needs as well to be colored properly and your final map will be produced. At this point, you can export all the layer into AutoCAD or into QuantumGIS or any other GIS software and produce your nice looking map. Thank you very much for watching and listening to this tutorial.